So in geometry, let us understand the important properties of circles. So first of all, a circle is defined as a locus of point such that they are equidistant from a fixed point. That fixed point is called as the center of the circle, and that fixed distance is called as the radius of the circle. So first, what is the area of circle? It is given by pi r square, where r is the radius of the circle. What is the circumference of the circle? Circumference means that if I have to draw the circle with a thread, that the units or the length of the thread needed is called as a circumference. It is also called as perimeter. So circumference is given as 2 pi r, which is same as pi d, because 2 r will become d, which is diameter of the circle. Then the next point is, there is a concept called chord of the circle. So chord is nothing but a line which joins any two points on the circumference of the circle. So if I draw the perpendicular from the center to the chord, it will always bisect the chord. That is point one. So this theorem itself can be probably understood in three different ways. The perpendicular bisector of the chord will always pass through the center of the circle. If I join the midpoint of the chord to the center of the circle, the angle made at the chord will be 90 degree, and so on. Basically, it is the same thing. Then the next important theorem can be, if I join these endpoints of the chord to the center, the angle made there, the angle made at the center by the chord is always double. It is always 2 theta, where the theta is the angle made by the chord at any point on the circumference of the circle in the same segment as the center. So if the chord AB is making an angle theta at the upper part, any point in the circumference of the circle, that AB is making 2 theta towards the center, assuming the center is also on the upper part of the chord AB. So that is one very important theorem. So from this we can take out that the angle made by the diameter at any point will be 90 degree, because the diameter is making 180 degree at the center of the circle. So these are some of the very, very important and the basic theorems which are very useful in solving the problems whenever it comes to the circles.